Alright, I'm Vince, and I modeled a paintball marker, my own version of a paintball marker. My goal is to put all the best features of a paintball marker into one design. This is when I found the best design, my comparison of products. One, two, I did three markers. And my main interests were the feet and neck type, the eye system, the trigger type, the ball defense, the on-off, the front grips. It's pretty much everything. I used to play a lot of paintball. I had a blow-up course in my backyard. Rough sketches, here's the feed neck design I was looking at. I wanted to incorporate a force fed hopper, which will sit down below so you don't have the hopper sitting above. That's always a huge target. People get real good. You can shoot a fly on the far side of the wall with some of these markers. Like you're talking a grand for a marker. So here's the force feed system. The force feed system is the best because it'll feed the balls up to 20 balls a second. You can fire 20 shots in 1 second, semi-automatic. Front grip designs, I wasn't sure what I wanted to do for front grip. Usually there's a regulator in there. This one has no reg. This one's got a regulator at 45 degrees. It all depends on comfort, how you want to hold the marker. So you can, it's all twisting and turning your torso, you know, getting the best shot. Triggers. There's a bunch of different trigger designs out there. Here's an alligator trigger where you rake your finger up and down the trigger. You can hit like 25 balls a second just, you know, just sitting there raking your finger up and down. Here's a bent double trigger. Here's another regular double trigger. That's your standard double trigger right there. That's all I was looking at. This is what I came up with my final design. You see there's the marker, and then I got the force feeder. It's actually on a belt. You'll see later on in some of my other pictures. It's on a belt or a backpack design. It sits behind you. So you have nothing up top. You know, that's nothing to shoot at right there. My gun body. This is the body I came up with. Open bolt system, lightweight, nice light bolt, less mass, less kickback. Sideways feed neck, like I said before, so you have no target up top. Covered eyes here, the eye covers, you got ball defense under there and the eyes under there, so when you get hit with the balls, it doesn't wreck your eye system. Volumizer in front, holds a little more air, makes your shots more consistent. Sticky grip, you can even see it up there, there's texture on the grip, so you're not dropping the thing, it's expensive. Nice small little drop forward, you want enough so that the tank sits back and you can use it as a stock and push against your shoulder so the gun's not kicking around when it's shooting. The on-off, you'll see a better picture of the on-off later, but the front part actually unscrews, so if you have a malfunction, there's no more air going into the gun. You just unscrew the front there, and no more air is going through the intake. Double trigger you see later too, just a standard double trigger was the easiest one after all kinds of designs. The backpack belt design right here, as you can see, this goes around your waist, it's behind you. That, of course, would be flexible tubing. Force fed, like I said, force feeder is the fastest way to feed. You don't have to depend on gravity, and it doesn't have to be on top of the gun. No hopper on the gun, it's a smaller target. First assembly, here's the gun body itself, the internals coming out. You can see the ball detents and the eyes. Lots of little parts. Springs. Assembly, there's a regulator, you got a gauge on the regulator, so you can see your input pressure, the macro line, there's your elbow. There's the grip frame. The grip frame comes apart in two, so when you get shot, you got to clean the inside of the gun, you have no problem. There's the grip, slides right off. There's the PC board, the trigger frame, double trigger. There's the drop forward and the on-off. You can see how this comes out front. This is going to come in and push a button on the CO2 tank, and that's what's going to let the air come in. There's the force feeder. It's going to go behind your back, exploded assembly. And this is a shot of my animation where the gun body is going to go clear, transparent, and you'll see the gun fire. There's a list of parts of the gun. And then of the regulator assembly and the force feeder assembly. And then in the user manual, I got general maintenance, keep it clean. You can remove the eye covers and clean everything if it does get in there. You're going to want to lube the bolt up. Force feeder system will eventually break balls, and that'll be a whole mess. You have to clean that out. You got a hydro compressed air tank at least every 2 years. There's another hydro two every four, I think. Ball detents will wear and will need to be replaced eventually. You always want to wear protective eye gear. I have a barrel plug or barrel condom on, so don't shoot nobody when they're not wearing eye gear. Never load foreign objects in the barrel, of course. Animations and website. animation took forever on a laptop. Long time. The rendered one took about 4 hours. Yeah. Now to go transparent to see the internals working. See the trigger pull too. And here's the website. Design goals, my whole write-up basically. Grand chart. And then down the bottom, I got the 2D drawings, alternative designs. They should make it way down at the bottom so you can organize them and put them in the same order. They get all out of order. There's the sketches. About it. You just made those on there, you saw, I got renders. Renders came pretty sharp. And it goes about it, saw the animation. Use manuals the same. Presentation, I got the presentation right in there. That's all, folks.
Okay.